Right here.
Hey guys.
Hi.
Welcome to another episode of the Grapevine Podcast.
Yes, welcome. Yay, welcome back. Different settings again. You know, we can't stay still. We're like gypsies, innit?
No.
Cannot stay still.
How often do you see black gypsies?
You don't,
innit?
But you just found a couple.
Not your stereotypical gypsies people.
Mm-mm.
But yeah, we're here. Hope you're all well. Thank you for tuning in. If you don't know, get to know. I feel like we've gone through so many changes since we last
was here. Yeah.
So since we last recorded here, we have got a new sponsor.
Mm-hmm.
Which you can see is our
Camo vodka.
We've got the bottles there. We've got the pouches here. Different kinds of flavors. So this is our new sponsor, Camo Vodka. www.camovodka.com.
Go check them out, guys.
We've got a discount code as well. Loyalty 10 for your 10% off your bottles, your pouches, whatever. So yeah,
go check them out.
I think we should have a little toast.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on, that's water. This is my Camo.
Let's have a little bit. I'm gonna try the Tropical.
I've got vanilla in
Tropical
here.
Tropical Island Girl.
I've got the vanilla. It smells absolutely amazing.
Mm-hmm.
I think, did I try the tropical beforehand? It was blueberry.
Blueberry.
Before, but that was way back in September, so mm-hmm. I haven't had this for a minute.
Yep.
So yeah, cheers. I feel weird not cheersing with the glass. Let me cheers with the glass and I'll take my shot. Cheers to another episode. I'll have a taste of this, then I'll wash it down with my water.
Oh gosh, that's strong.
Mm-hmm.
Getting used to it now though, I'm getting used to it.
We've got no choice.
So, guys, as you know, we're on Hot 92 every Tuesday.
Sure.
Doing our thing. Tune in. Check it out. 6 to 8 p.m.
Hot92.net. You can access it from wherever you are.
Yep.
You don't have to be in Brum.
Nope.
So you can get it on the app or just just type it into your phone or whatever. Do you know what I mean? We always put the link up on our story. So if you're following us on Instagram, at grapevine.podcast, and you'll see it on our story every Tuesday.
Every Tuesday. Yeah, man. Go listen.
We feel like we've been getting a lot of engagement within the radio.
Oh, lately. Yeah. It's definitely picked up.
Nice.
It has.
Really, really nice.
People are starting to understand we're there every Tuesday. They didn't get it before. Now they know. And we literally have been, you know, giving them the celebrity news, updating on what's new, what's going on with us, what's going on with our podcast. So like I said, you needs to tune in. Gots to be done.
Yeah, I feel like the radio listeners get a lot of us as people.
They do.
You know, they get a lot of our just our natural vibe, because it's like we've come in from work straight away and we just get on the radio. You know, we've got the kids in the house as well, and it's like an organic side of us.
Yeah, it is. I think they're enjoying it. Mm-hmm. I mean, if they're complaining, we don't know.
No, but we
don't know if there's a complaints line for Hot 92. Yes, guys, so we wanted to celebrate Mother's Day. Mother's Day is on Sunday, so this is our Mother's Day episode. I feel like I took the Camel vodka and I'm feeling a bit tipsy at the moment, to be honest.
It does say on the back as well, people, it says, have fun, but please drink responsibly. So, yeah, it is strong. It's lovely, but it's strong. Just take time, because I just said to Michelle, says I feel like we need to be sponsored by cranberry juice, because this is a little bit strong.
If anybody's created some different type of cranberry juice, then bring it on, please. It's about time we had some non-alcoholic versions of this, because boy, it's a lot. But yeah, it's Mother's Day on Sunday.
Yay.
You looking forward to it?
I'm looking forward to the rest.
Really?
I'm literally just gonna, yeah. I feel like I'm gonna just cook and then just sit down and do nothing.
Yeah, I know.
And it's an excuse to do nothing.
Yeah.
We don't really have to. I mean, it'd be nice if we could have dinner cooked for us, but I want to cook for my mum, because she's been away the past few weeks, and I just feel like I need to just cook for her.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That'd be nice.
But then after that, I'm sitting down and relaxing.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
My brother's cooking for my mum.
Oh, is he?
He's took the dinner spot.
Oh, so lovely.
I've been allocated the lunch spot.
Oh, So you don't have to call.
So I don't know what I'm going to do, to be honest. I feel like I might, because she's not going to see this until when we put it out on Sunday, I might put a little something together and do a little brunch maybe.
Yeah.
So that's what I think we'll do. We're going to go church together on Sunday. Nice. It's our first year without Nan. So we're going to go to the graveside and put some flowers down and spend some time with her. And that's it, really. It's quite an emotional day because it's like I've never celebrated a Mother's Day without Nan, ever. So to celebrate this one, it's going to be absolutely... But I know she's around. I know she's around. So it's one of those ones. But yeah, it should be nice. I don't feel like I'm that fussed on it, to be honest. You know, even though I've got my own kids, I feel like I'm concentrating more on making mum's nice.
Yeah,
rather than doing mine, because, you know, I'm a nanny and I've got my kids. But, you know, I feel like at this point, I feel like I'm too young to have the takeover day. If you get what I mean. Yeah. I feel like my mum still has a big importance and impact on the day. So mum will get some of that. Well, she'll get the majority of it.
I know what you mean. That's why I said I just want to cook for my mum.
Yeah.
It was weird because she'd just come back from Jamaica and she'd been gone like 3 weeks. And I swear, my daughter was just missing her.
Yeah.
Oh, I want nanny. Oh, let me FaceTime her. Like, every minute she's voice noting.
I can imagine. Her
because she's, and it, when she's gone, it was like I was taking on all the roles that she usually does.
Yeah.
So on a Friday, she'd take my niece's daughter to her dad's. Mm. That was like, that's something that my mum does every Friday evening.
Yeah.
And then when she was gone, I was doing it. I was taking on all the roles. Yeah. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, so no, I hear like that.
Everybody was just missing her. And it really makes you feel like, oh my gosh, she does so much.
Yeah.
Do you get what I mean?
You don't realise, do you? And it is mad because obviously, like your mum, my mum, they all take that big role in the kids' life, so they do like really miss them when they're not around. So you do feel the heat when they go on holiday or they got other things to do. You really do feel it. It's hard, but we were saying this on the radio, like it's hard, like I was saying, I'm a nan, so it's hard living up to that expectation of the nans that were generations back, because they were so on the ball with this nan thing. Like, because they were just on the ball. They were like second mums.
We were saying on the radio as well, weren't we, that they were different to our generation.
Of course.
Of nans.
Yeah.
Because they always seemed to be home.
Yeah.
No matter what.
Exactly.
They were always there.
Yeah. My nan was always at home. I could go there. If she wasn't home, like I was saying, I'd pick up the phone. I'd be like, where are you at? Do you ask permission to be out doing what you're doing right now? Because you're needed. It's really mad that we actually... evolving into grandmas or nans ourselves, and we're actually not going to be the same, because I know I'm not in the same place as my nan was. And I know that if my daughter was to bring the kids to mine, the majority of the time she wouldn't find me there. To be fair, do you get what I mean? Definitely. Definitely.
Because my son's the eldest, he'll be the first one to make me a nan. And I know that if he was to do it even in 5-6 years time, I won't be ready.
Nah. It's not. I 100% it's 100% get it. This freaking vodka's got to be. You can laugh.
Oh, come but, on, what you doing?
I can definitely vouch for that fact, because I know that when it comes down to it, we ain't staying in the house. It's that age group.
Yeah.
It's completely different. We're still trying to get up and have a party night and still enjoy life and socialize and still find ourselves. It's a complete different place that we're in compared to our grandma. So, you know, later on down the line, grandkids, I'll be ready to sit down 24/7 and do all the nanny duties. But right now, nanny's trying to be her own person still.
Oh, yeah.
It's hard. But yeah. So I feel like because it's Mother's Day, probably we could touch on the fact that, you know, what do we enjoy about our motherhood? What parts of it do you enjoy?
I liked it when they were young.
Mm.
I liked that whole toddler phase
and
all of that. I felt like I had the energy for it back then.
Yeah.
I wouldn't now.
God, yeah.
I wouldn't be able to do it now. But now I feel like it was, that stage was lovely, just watching them grow and develop. You know, learning their words and all the milestones, like starting school. All of those things, I just love them, you know, just those first memories of them doing and saying things, and it's nice.
It is.
All of that.
It is.
I mean, now that they're older, I mean, they're still developing, they're still growing and learning, but it's in a different way, isn't it?
Yeah. It is. They are, but they don't need you as much.
Not as much now. And it does make me feel a little bit sad sometimes because I think, oh my gosh, like, I want to be able to pick out my daughter's clothes. Like, she's starting to pick out her own clothes now.
Is she?
Yeah, yeah. So she's on a River Island vibe at the moment.
Is she?
Yeah.
Check her out.
Yeah, so I was a bit like, okay. Chess Hai. Do you know what I mean? She always wants to go River Island for everything. So we went to River Island not long ago, and she was like, oh, Mum, can I have these sliders? Can I have this? And she was spending all her, like, Christmas money and things like that and Christmas vouchers.
Yeah.
And she was putting things together, and I was watching her put the little clothes together, and I thought, oh, okay, a little fashionista.
Oh, hilarious. Strange. Check her out.
It just feels weird, like, seeing them develop like that.
It's going really fast, though, because, you know, obviously our kids are the same age, the youngest ones, but... they're like big people now. They're turning 8 this year. So it's just like, where did the time go?
It has gone really fast. It don't seem like 2 minutes from maternity leave.
Definitely.
Taking them to that little playgroup down the
exactly.
road.
Exactly. Watching them freaking back there, bully beefing everybody down in that place. I swear to God, the moms must have thought, why do they keep bringing their children to come bully beef the kids out of here? Because it was terrible. But now they're big people. It's just mad. It's mad when I see their little pictures pop up and I see how much they've grown. But it is nice. I think you're right. It is nice when they were younger. I feel like being a nan as well, now I'm getting a full munch of my grandkids. I'm really enjoying it. And it does remind me of when my kids were small. But it's even better.
Because all your family look alike, that's why. So it does. So you can look at them and say,
I know. And
okay.
It makes you feel like it's like a younger version. It does. Because she's like a younger version of my daughter, my granddaughter is. And my grandson, he's like a younger version of his dad.
Yeah.
They're absolutely gorgeous. So when I'm around them, I swear to God, they just make me feel like, oh, I just can't. I'm like, these are my grandkids. Like, I'm so excited. Now I get why my nan used to get so excited over us.
You guys.
I get it. And then it's nice because you get to hand them back. As much as I love them, you can actually hand them back and you just get little pieces of them and they love you because you just come in. Do your
spoil
little bit
them
and then go about your business. Yeah. It's nice. So I'm enjoying that side of it. From the kids' perspective, I feel like even now I do love it because I have big grown-ass daughters and I know that we have a lot of banter, a lot of chat, a lot of talk, but it's nice because I actually can talk to them and we can actually sit down and catch a vibe as well. As much as we're mother and daughters, like... they're my protectors. I can't lie. They're actually there to make sure mummy's cool, mummy's all right. And I actually know that my little babies will look after me when I'm an old bitch and I'm out here in these streets. They will actually look after me. So it's nice. I'm enjoying that bit. Because as much as my middle daughter, my last daughter, gets on my nerves, mad Shante, as much as she gets on my nerves, like there's an element of her, there's love there. There's this mad love.
There is.
And it's just like, she's crazy, but I love it. I love the fact that she's around. I love the fact that my little munchkin, my little son's around. I've got my big ass son, 25 years old, coming up. And it's just nice. It is nice that I know all my babies are healthy. So
exactly
I'm enjoying it.
It's that gratitude, isn't it?
It is. And I'm just grateful. I'm grateful. So it's just a matter of enjoying it because you don't know when your time is your time.
I know.
Mother's Day is a blessing anyway, all in all.
It sure is. So just enjoy it, guys. Mm-hmm. Hopefully by the time you see this, you should be enjoying it or would have enjoyed it.
Yeah.
So yeah, just enjoy. It's just gratitude for the people that you've got in your life, your children, you know, your role models as well.
Appreciate it, man, because you don't know what next year brings. So go see your mamas, go see your aunties, go see all the women in your life. That bring you up, yeah, man, and just make them feel special because I'm telling you, it's not easy. A woman's work's never done. And when you're a mother, I'm telling you, you never just have a solo lifestyle. It is always constantly, you know, you're thinking about this, you're thinking about that, and it's always the kids.
It's never about you.
No.
And you can't switch off from being a mum even when you're trying to catch a break.
Nope.
You can't switch off.
No,
there's
sir.
There's been times when I've wanted to, like, just zone out and switch my phone off. And I think, oh no, because what if a school call? Or what if you cannot switch off?
No, sir. It's not even a thought. So it's not easy. So this one little day of appreciation. We did say on the radio, you know, you baby fathers, if you want, text your baby mum. It might not be on good terms. It might be a bit rocky, you know. But I feel like it's just an appreciation for who's looking after that child on a day-to-day basis, organizing, making sure they're clean, making sure food cooked, make sure they get to school. It's not easy because today's life ain't yesterday's life. It's hard. Yeah. It's super hard.
We plan our lives mm-hmm. around the children. We don't plan the children around our lives, if that makes sense. Mm-hmm. They come first.
They do.
And it's like, okay, well, I can work these hours only because I've got childcare, like, or I've got to, you know what I mean?
Yep.
We plan everything around them.
Yep. So if you have a baby mum and she pisses you off all day, every day, and she gives you a lot of stress, I don't even need to understand the situation. I just think it's not a harm to just send that Mother's Day message and close your eyes, send the message, make it guan, put it out there in the universe. You know, it is what it is. And vice versa, for when Father's Day comes up, we will give you the same message for the fathers too. So don't worry about it. Don't think we're all one-sided because it's not that. It's just that I feel like I know that I don't receive the messages for whatever reason. I can't explain. But it doesn't hurt me now, but it just makes me think, oh, okay, motherfucker. But at the same time, it just makes you wonder, you know, I know how many things I do. I know how much I plan my life around the child. Mm-hmm. It's just nice for that little piece of appreciation sometimes.
It's just a text. If you're not going to do the card and the present thing or a phone call, then a text is sufficient because it does make a difference. Makes, you know, that woman feel like, okay, everything I'm doing, at least it's been recognised slightly.
And that's it.
You know.
That's just it, that little piece of minute part there. Mm. That's it.
Yeah.
All we need.
No more shedding tears over no text messages. I've stopped that now. I'll just get on with it. And I just know I'm doing my bit.
Yeah, man. What do you feel like we should move on to now, Sophia? A little bit of gossip?
Well, on the radio, because this is where most of our gossip formulates from, we were talking about the Neil situation, weren't we?
Week. Definitely. And Neil's a hot mess, man. I'm not even going to lie. Like,
under that hat, there's a lot going on.
Like, I'm quite baffled, to be fair. There's a lot of shit going on in the limelight at the moment with celebrities where they're doing a lot of this. Obviously, the cheat. It's just an ongoing thing. Mm. But I feel like there's levels to the shit. Like, there's cheating, and there's fucking up your whole life.
Yeah.
I think with Neil, he's definitely took it to a next level. If anyone's not clear on what Neil's been going on with, Neil's married to Crystal, and he's fathered his second child this week with a side chick, and his divorce has now come through from Crystal. She's obviously split up with him, so she's realised, I think he was sleeping with prostitutes unprotected.
Yeah, he was.
And all that kind of mad shit.
Last year.
Yeah. So it must have urged them to kind of split up, and then now they're divorced. So it's just absolutely weird when you hear all that shit going on. And I don't know with Neil, I think you look at him and you feel like he's a bit more, got more bit about him than that. Yeah, he does come across, even his whole persona.
Yeah, I think probably because he dresses a certain way and he's that smart, suave kind of, you wouldn't expect
sophisticated
that kind of behavior
from
him. You'd expect him to carry on a little bit better, more mature.
But do you think it's... What makes him feel like he can sleep with a prostitute and protected? I don't get it.
I know, this is the problem. And then go back home to his missus that he's got children with. Like, there's got to be that level of respect. I don't think that was there. It's not a joke.
But is that because he's famous? Is it because money's rolling in? Is it because he's a different stature to his wife? Because he, you know, when a man's earning that much money, does he feel like, I don't really give a fuck what she thinks. I'm just going to do what I want to do. If this is what I feel to do right now, to here today, then I'm going to do it.
It could be that.
And I can do it.
Yeah. Yeah. It's like what we were saying when we were talking about R. Kelly and the fact that we felt like he thought he was invincible.
Yeah, he did.
He thought he was invincible. Maybe Neil's got that kind of vibe as well. I feel like they've all got a little touch of that kind of, I'm invincible, I can do what I like and get away with it.
Definitely do what you like. Because I don't feel like the marriage vows mean much.
No. Well, why are they getting married then?
Because it's just the natural progression from whatever they're doing. I feel like then they obviously fall in love. They get caught up. Marriage feels like it's a natural progression. Mm. You're having babies, etc., etc. It happens, doesn't it? And sometimes men find the woman that they feel like is going to be that woman that stands behind them. And I've been seeing a lot of this lately where they're talking about, you know, and men actually progresses more when they've got one woman than when they've got a lot of women. So maybe sometimes at that point in their life, they do want to just sit down with that one woman and progress from there and see where they can go to the next levels. But I don't know if sometimes the man appreciates how much the woman does do for them, even in that scenario where he might bring in the money. I don't know if they appreciate the support they give them, the emotional, support, the moral, everything.
It's all of that. I mean, she's got her own stuff going on, hasn't she, business-wise? So it's not like she was relying on him for money, but she must have been there supporting him in everything that he was doing. And you're right, I feel like a man does need that one particular woman to kind of be there.
It seems to be facts. They say a man actually seems to grow more and is more concentrated when he has one woman behind him. And that's why some men choose to go down that route, get married, because they know that they're going to make more of whatever they're putting themselves into because that woman is standing by them and pushing them to keep that goal in mind.
Yeah,
I mean, it's easier as well. I mean, who's got time for 10, 2, 3, 4 women and to be, especially in this credit crunch?
I know. Well, this is the thing, like, who's got the time, who's got the energy, who's got the money? And I feel like it's more stressful for the man when he's running around doing all that anyway.
Yeah, of course.
It's going to be more stressful. So it is better that you just sit down with one person and, you know, they are your backbone, you support and lean on each other and just do what you've got to do to be that, you know, power couple, really. It's better than all of this side chick business. Because where's that got him now? Is he even with the side chick?
I don't know if he's even with her like that, but he's definitely welcomed the second child with the side chick into this world, so congratulations to them for that. But it's just like, I don't know, there's just better ways to go about stuff. If he's not happy, if he has a different sexual level to his wife, if there's things that he wants to explore sexually, he should be letting her know that. Whether it breaks them or not, it's better that she knows that, and she knows that he can't do without these things, so she's aware and she can make that decision if she wants to be around it or not. I would much more prefer personally that the person shares those type of feelings with me rather than just go out and do whatever they want to do and then come home and act like I didn't do shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because
it's important. It's that communication.
It is.
Maybe I've got the urge to do this. Let's sit down and talk.
She might have well have been in on it. She might have said, yeah, you know what? That's cool. But then maybe part of what he's doing doesn't include having his wife in it, and that helps him to have more of a height on the situation. Do you know what I mean? Because they're running behind someone's back.
It gives you that thrill.
Yeah, a percentage of the time it is for that. People do it and there is a thrill that they get off it. Mm. So, you know, doing it that way might be easier than doing it where you're being up front. Yeah. So.
But then being up front, like, say, for example, if he was to say, okay, this is what I want to do. Like, they could have started having the threesomes or doing the whole swingers thing. Mm. And they could have done that. There are options. You don't have to just go out and find your side chick.
But, yeah. I don't know. I feel like his way of doing it is not necessarily the best way. I feel like he could have gone about that whole situation a different way.
He could have, because he's a grown-ass man. He's older than us, right?
Probably a little bit.
Yeah, he's a little bit older than us. So he's in his 40s. He's not a kid.
Mm-mm.
You know, his hormones aren't flying everywhere and all of that. He could have a conversation with his wife. Take that time to do that. Boy, sir. These celebrities, eh? Well, good luck to them is all I can say. I mean, she's done all right, though, hasn't she? Financially, out of it. But I think I'd still prefer my husband.
Definitely. Definitely. It's different. But, yeah. On the other hand, though, Chris Brown's been in town. He's been hitting Birmingham, Manchester, London. He's been in the UK, roaming around, doing his little 1-2 dance moves, hypnotic, granic, and all that good stuff. Like, I didn't personally get to go and see him because I'm not that fussed.
No, I'm not that fussed about Chris Brown. I like him, but I'm not that fussed to go and pay all that big money to go and watch him. Nah.
But nobody walked away with bad reviews. Everyone seems to come back and said, you know,
everybody
it was a good...
Everybody said they've had a good time. He's a very good performer as well, though, isn't he? So it was inevitable he put on a good show.
Yeah.
But I think he'll be back. He will be back.
Well, you know what? It's nice after all this time that he's been able to come to the UK and actually start to, you know, make some money off all his fans in the UK, because I think a lot of them have travelled... But people have travelled all over the world to see him because they couldn't get him in the UK. So it is nice for him to finally come here for the people that haven't seen him.
Exactly.
But
I know my friend went to Paris to go and watch him.
And which is nice. It is nice. And you know what? Chris is always going to be special to everyone's heart because of the fact that he feel like you've grown up on him. You've seen him when he was young. Yeah. Now he's a big man and all that kind of stuff. Obviously.
And he was such a little kid when he came
he
out.
Was.
So
he was.
It's been nice to see him evolve and grow into the man he is, man.
And it is, and it's nice. And obviously, the scenario that he had with Rihanna has give people this judgmental side of every situation that he's in, and he can't get no ease off that situation. But at the same time, he has definitely done himself justice. He's kept his music out there, he's kept it alive. He's really worked really hard, so he's deserved this moment. But I ain't even gonna lie, he don't look right to me. I don't know. This is not the Chris Brown that I loved and enjoyed. I feel like he looks sick.
Well, my friend sent me a video of a couple of videos of his performance.
Yeah.
And I was watching him dance and everything. I was thinking, yeah, you can still move this and that. But there was one point where it was really close up, actually, and she zoomed in.
Mm.
I thought, why does his face look so maga?
Yeah, he does look like he's lost a lot of weight. I mean, if you're hypnotic and if you're sitting there and you're doing all of this every day, all day, hypnotic, chronic, of course you're going to lose like a weight, but... I don't know. I don't feel like if he pulled me on stage, I'll be that excited. Like I see all these women getting, it wouldn't really excite me too tough, to be fair.
It's never excited me like that anyway.
Not necessarily, no, but it's just like, I feel like there's a couple of ways he could have gone in his adulthood. And I feel like he could have gone sophisticated.
Yeah.
He could have gone, you know, other ways, but...
You mean when he'd come out in a different look, you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I get it. It's hip. It's what's going on now. I get it. He's always stayed relevant. He's always kept up to date with the music and he's always worked with the latest artists. And I love that about him. But I'm not going to lie, from an attractive point of view, Breezy ain't the one.
Yeah, he's not. I've never fancied him, to be honest.
He just doesn't look... Can I say it? He doesn't look healthy.
Yeah. But, you know what, a lot of these celebrities, remember, they take things to keep them going, don't they?
Well, I don't know about
It could be something like that, maybe.
I don't know. I can't vouch for that, but I just know that from a visual perspective, watching all these videos of all the young girls sitting on the chair, getting a dance, getting a wonderful dance, it didn't do a goddamn thing for me at all. But again, it's just nice seeing him out there doing his thing. That's all I can say, because... You know, you'd have to get me a stair lift to get on the stage anyway if you pull me up. I need a stair lift. I need a seat with a cushion. That dance needs to be a bit further away. You get what I mean? I don't know. It is what it is. But it's nice. It's lovely. Yeah. Nevertheless.
Well done, Chris.
Yep. Well done, Chris. Chris Rock, though. Speaking of Chris's.
Chris Rock. I still need to watch his thing on Netflix, you know.
He's special.
Yeah, I need to watch it. I keep saying, yeah, I'll do it. And I think I might just do it on Sunday. But it's Mother's Day and I put my foot up.
It's a good one.
Chill out.
Touched on a lot of stuff. He ripped everybody to pieces. And it just made me laugh because I just feel like nobody got away with anything in that special. He spoke on every and everything. Kardashians, Will Smith, Jada Pinkett, everybody. And... I don't know, he's back. That's all I can say. Because I've never been a Chris Rock fan. Mm. I've never really found him that funny. But in this specific special, I felt like he was really on point with it. And if anything, it just brought... I don't know, because he's older Chris, there's something about him now that gives you that je ne sais quoi. Yeah. Like, his comedy as, like... It's like vintage wine, like it's aged.
Like he's got better.
Yeah, he's got.
I've always loved him.
Because I never liked him. I've never liked him, but there's something about him now
that you prefer.
Compared to him when he was younger. He was like, really annoying. I found him really annoying.
I've always liked him.
I found him annoying, whereas now there's not that much energy. Like he's a bit more older, chilled. A bit more mellow. Mm. So his jokes are come across a bit different, they're presented differently. Mm. But. I enjoyed it because the things that he hit on was so on point. It was hilarious. He did hit on the over 40s. Not happy with you for that. Talking about how we got good pum-pum, but at the same time, we have problems and we always want something fixing.
What?
If it's a car, if it's a roof, if it's a... which was hilarious. I can't lie because he did hit the nail on the coffin. I can't lie.
But we don't it depends on how independent you are, though, isn't it?
Listen.
I don't like asking
what he said, right? I'm not going to lie, it was proper on point. But it, I don't know, I think men are so in touch with the way females are going on these days. Mm. They're seeing the way we behave and they're literally watching it like a fucking animal in the zoo. And they literally are just taking notes and then they're just coming back full force, because I'm telling you, there's a lot of points that they're making. They're proper on point. Mm. Proper on point.
I can't wait to watch.
So, yeah.
There's a recommendation for you guys.
Yeah, man.
If you're a Chris Rock fan, go and check it out. It's on Netflix now. What was it called?
I can't remember. I put it down on here. but yeah, man. Enjoyed it. So I feel like we're giving you a lot of recommendation. We give you a lot of something to, you know, marinate. You know, it goes. But right now, I think we need to give you a music section, because that's what we do. You know how it goes.
It just feels like a long time since we've sat at this desk and done the music.
Yeah, it has been. Mm. It has been. So yeah, that's what we're going to give you now. Yes, guys, we're there for the music section. You know, we ain't done it for a minute, so we're just going to bring a little something, some of our favourite tunes that we know we're playing and it has influenced our children.
Yeah.
In my case, my children and my brothers. So we're just going to play them one little two tunes and we'll be out of your ear, eh? First one, always the same thing, and we argue about this. It's definitely me and my brothers. And it's definitely got to be Tribe Called Quest, because they would not know about Tribe Called Quest if it wasn't me. And they won't admit it. And they'll be like, we knew about them. No, you wouldn't. You wouldn't know. But they try it anyway. But definitely Tribe Called Quest has to be the first one. All my family love them. I love them. You say it's old school. It's going to be old school. We're in our 40s. It is what it is. So I'm going to give you this one, because you know this tune. You confuse things. Should I just sit out or come on? Let me find my way. Now you put my heart for the evening. Kiss my cheek, move in, you confuse things. Should I just sit out or come harder? Let me find my way. Now why you wanna go and do that, love, ma? Make it taste for me towards you harder. Killing me, just when I think we there. You got the whole vibe and the folks in the air. Telling me about next man. But next man ain't the nigga with the plan. Got your heart in mind.
Never gets old. 90s.
And you know what? It doesn't.
Doesn't.
Q-Tip, Tribe Called Quest, the whole shebang. You can't fault it.
I feel like I'm going to go for a Nas track. Which one did I go for?
It ain't hard to tell.
Yeah, so it ain't hard to tell. You just, I can hear him rapping this in his room constantly. So yeah. I've always loved a bit of Nas. But yeah, he definitely got this from me and his dad, to be fair.
Nas.
This is young Nas. But you see, he's another one that's evolved as well. And he's still wicked today.
Of course. You're feeling like grill, it ain't hard to tell. I keep a skill like Shaquille holds a pill. Vocabulary spills up. I think Nas, he never fucking ages. He always looks good. So, yep.
I wouldn't have said no then.
I wouldn't say no now. Hear that. My next one that I know definitely my family tee from me all the time and I still try to act like it's oblivious to them is definitely Slum Village. It's definitely Slum Village. They're always teething every Slum Village tune. It's annoying. I hear my brother using it for cooking. I'm using it in the shower. Like, they're terrible and they blatantly act like it's not come from me, and it definitely has.
I feel like that has
definitely come from me. That's freaking out of order. But yeah, I'm gonna give you a little bit of Slum. In the hands of the slum now, take it away from where it comes from now. A lot of you cats in the music business, shiftless, I put you on the shit list. Did your intuition say the shit on me? I'ma just flick your ears, yo, you hear me be D'Angelo, play your piano. JG flipping up the beat for me. Hold tight with my tear and my nigga T3. Bust a bus, watch out for who you trust. I be shy, he the show blood that I be. It's Q-Tip, man.
Yeah.
All Q-Tip. But yeah, That's a little bit of Slum Village for you. To my brothers out there, I know what it is.
Right, my turn. Right, I'm going to something that my daughter's just on at the moment. She just kills me with it. Now, back in the day, obviously, I used to love my UK garage. Still play it in the house sometimes when I'm on a mad one, do my cleaning, I'll just buss it loud. And she'd caught on to a couple of tracks that she liked that were kind of like more soulful.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, she just caught on to Wookiee Battle. And she wanted to learn the lyrics and all these things. I sent her to her dad's one weekend and she came back and she'd written all the lyrics out. She must have listened to him. She must have asked him to put it on or whatever. And she'd written all the lyrics out and everything. I couldn't believe it.
Mm-mm.
I was like, wow. In a little notebook. I was like, okay. And I says, I bet you don't know it off by heart though. And she literally told me to put it on and she did her little dance. And she literally let me film her.
That's hilarious.
She's funny. But she knew all the lyrics better than me.
That's
as well.
Good. Check her out. Okay. Big up Little Miss, eh?
Mm-hmm.
Little Miss.
But yeah, she loves this tune.
Little Miss, no thank you. So it's funny how they get gospel on that bit there, yeah.
Yeah, but she actually analysed the lyrics and she was saying to me, like, oh, Mum, it's really positive, you know.
It is.
I was like, yeah, it's good. But I never, when you're young and you're dancing around to it in a club, you don't take that on board.
Definitely
but when
not.
You deep the lyrics, it's quite deep tune.
Next one for me. I'm going to go for Naughty by Nature. Again, family favourite. They always try to teeth it. It's one of them ones, so I'm gonna give you this one. Yeah, you know me. Yeah, you know me. You know me, old PP. You know me, old PP. You know me, old PP. Listen, Tretch was the one.
You used to love Tretch.
I still love Tretch.
Tretch
still looks good.
Handsome. The dark chocolate.
Yeah.
Vinny was cute though. I liked Vinny.
Vinny was
as well.
Cute, but he was a bit goofy.
You think?
Yeah, I felt like he was goofy. Tretch was the one.
Tretch seemed more like manly, like. And it that.
You know what, old baby? What's your last one, love?
My last one. Another one of my son's bangers, I say. It's not his banger, it was my banger first. And actually, I was just saying to Michelle that this song actually popped up on an Instagram post that I saw today. They'd compiled like a group of tracks, hip hop tracks, that were 30 years old this year, and that was one of them. I couldn't believe it. I was like, huh?
But
that's
old.
30 years old. But it still sounds good. Electric Relaxation. Another Tribe. See, I'm about to take the kick. Stretch out your legs, let me make it ball. Drive you insane, drive you up the wall. Staring at your own piece, very strong. Stronger than pride, stronger than Teflon. Take it on the air. You know the thing about this era of music? You could actually just listen to the instrumentals. You could be my mama and I'll be your
boy.
Yeah.
Oh boy. You could be a shorty in my ill convoy. Not to come across as a thug or a hood. You got the good, like Madeline Wood. By the way, my name's Mike, the 5 foot freak.
Together by the end of the week.
She said no. Yo, rest in peace, Malik, man. But yeah, Tribal Quest was definitely the one. Definitely the one. They are. Can't fault it. Can't do without
and we
it.
We didn't plan all that tribe stuff.
No.
Literally, just
but they're always going to be up in
how
that.
How influential they are.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Mm-hmm.
And how their music lives on, man, all these years later.
Definitely. Definitely. Oh, you know what? I've just spotted Blackstreet.
Oh.
You know, I can't do nothing without Blackstreet.
No, you can't.
Definitely this particular song, I feel like me and my brother connect. I don't know why, but this always, if we ever play this family things, we always end up having a little 1-2 dance. Played the wrong one. We end up having a family dance, so. Coming to you from the Blackstreet. Girl, you turn me on and make me wanna scream for.
I like the way you work.
Like the way you work it, baby.
Baby, work it out.
Come on.
You got it going on.
Work it out, work it out, yeah.
Let me scream and shout. Bum bum and da da da. Da da da. Da da.
Definitely one of the best groups of that time.
Listen, to the day I die. To the day I die. But yes, guys, thanks for joining us for another week. We're nearing the end. Should give me a little quote of the week.
Should, if I had one.
Oh, God.
I forgot about that bit.
Yes, ma'am. I'm going to give him a little quote of the week.
Ooh. Let's see if
I can find a nice quote. But while Soph is doing that, yes, guys, go add, like, subscribe, add us on the grapevine.podcast Instagram. You know, like this video, you know, go subscribe, get your notifications through that, you know, when us bitches pop up and we got something new going on. Get it done. Go add Camel on
camelvodka.com.
So www.camelvodka.com, and go add them on Instagram, Camel Vodka. All easy, no hard shit. And actually, a home of Camel Vodka down at Channel 7 in Digbeth, Birmingham. Go check them out for your latest podcast. If you want to go down there and record, always open to all that good stuff. And last of all, go check us out on Hot 92.
Yeah, on every Tuesday. Hot92.net.
6 to 8.
6 till 8 p.m. So, yeah, I think that's everything, isn't
it? Yep.
But yeah, like Shell said, like, subscribe, comment on anything that you feel like, you know, you liked about this video. Just let us know.
Yeah, man.
But yeah, little quote of the week.
Quote of the week.
And I've tried to get a longer one today because Michelle always says they're too short.
There's one short one. She took on Rio deal was short.
So I've tried to get a little bit of a longer one. Try to go positive. Got to start the week. I'll end the week with on a positive note. Okay, you're braver than you believe and stronger than you seem and smarter than you think. Keep your face to the sunshine and you cannot see a shadow.
Yeah, man. That was a bit longer, yeah. Keep your heads up, guys. Keep doing what you're doing. All the mums working hard, making sure the kids are all fed and looked after, clean. All the little things that we provide for the kids along with the big things, you know, just keep doing what you're doing, man.
That's all you can do. And just stay grateful in everything that you do as well.
It's a thankless job, but we don't do it for that. We do it because we love our kids, so.
That's exactly it.
We'll see you on the next episode. May have a guest, may not. You never know. Tune in and you'll find out.
We like to keep you on your toes.
So till next time, take care, guys. Bye.